64 Kilobyte Productions presents I got this camera at the thrift store today. It's not the first time I found a digital camera at the thrift store, but it's the first time I found one that I would consider to be still usable today for taking photos and not some relic from the 90s that's really not worth using anymore. But this one's from 2002. Got it for $9.99. It's the Kodak EasyShare DX4330 with Kodak Color Science inside. 3.1 megapixel CCD image sensor. Also has a real viewfinder and a flash. And one of these is the microphone because it can also take video, although the video resolution is so low you don't want to use it. Came with the lens cap. And there's the Kodak Retinar lens with 3x optical zoom. Has auto picture rotation. And it's compatible with an EasyShare camera dock. There's a connector on the bottom for that. On this side is the DC 3-volt power input, but you don't need to use that because it can also run on 2 AA batteries. And it also supports a CRV3 lithium ion rechargeable battery pack, which is like 2 AA batteries stuck together into one package. And you can also use nickel metal hydride AA batteries in there. Made in China, designed in Japan. There's the tripod mount and the connector for the docking station. On this side, there's a video output. Looks like a 2.5 millimeter jack there. And there's the SD card slot. Also works with MMC cards, which were like the predecessor to SD cards. And there's a USB connector, but it's not a standard connector that you find on cameras. It's more like a miniaturized version of one of these things that you see on printers. So I don't have a cable which fits that, but that's no big deal because I can just take out the card and use a card reader. And it came with the lowest capacity SD card I've ever seen, 128 megabytes, which I suspect still would have cost quite a bit of money in 2002. It will also accept larger capacity SD cards. I tried this 1 gig card and it worked just fine, so it should work with any regular SD card, but will not work with SDHC cards because those weren't invented yet in 2002. So there we can click in the card and close the little door, and now it's ready to turn on. And that's auto mode. See the lens pops out. And then if you use the zoom, it actually goes in when you zoom because of the way the lens works. See, it's zoomed out and it's zoomed in. You can also see the viewfinder thing adjusting. In the menus, you get a self timer, image storage. It has also 16 megs of internal memory, which it can use if you don't have a card installed, or I guess if the card is full, as a backup. Exposure compensation, long time exposure, I guess for low light or special effects. Picture quality, I do not know if that changes the size or just the quality of the JPEG files. I've only used it in the best setting, which is 3 megapixels. You can set the time and date. Let me see if you can turn the date stamp off. Oh yeah, that's good, because I don't like a date stamp on my photos. Orientation sensor, so if you're holding it like that, the pictures will come out vertical on your computer. And the setup menu. Default print quality, quick view, live view, shutter sound, date and time setting, which I didn't set, so it's on 2002. Video output, NTSC or PAL, and language, and you can format the SD card. And there it is, version 1.0000. I don't know if they ever did any updates or if it's even possible to update on the firmware on this. So there's your live preview. And for doing close-ups, well, there's different modes here, but there's like, what is it, sports, which is like a higher shutter, faster shutter speed, night, which is a slower shutter speed, landscape, which I guess focuses far away, and close-up, which focuses, I think it says up to 28 inches away from the lens. You have to use close-up mode or else it'll be out of focus. And also, if you want to turn off the LCD while you're taking photos, just push the OK button and it turns it off to save battery power, and then you can just use the viewfinder through there. And then there's the video mode here. Let's see if there's a setup for that. I don't think there's a special setting for that. So it's just very low resolution videos. I'll put in a little test video I recorded using it so you can see a quick sample of what the quality is like. Testing the Kodak EasyShare DX4330 camera, digital camera from 2002. Bought it at a thrift store for 10 bucks. The video mode on this thing is low resolution and low quality, but for the standards of 2002, it's not too bad. And it focuses once when you start the video and stays at that focus. So at least you don't get that ticking noise from the autofocus that a lot of digital cameras do in video mode. Even new ones today still do that. Let's see if zoom works in video mode. Nope, you can't zoom. But I think you can zoom first and then take the video. But you can't zoom while recording. And there's the Sony DigiLake camera I used to record the first part of this video. So that's the Kodak EasyShare DX4330 digital camera from 2002. Over 10 years old by this point, but still pretty usable. And I'm sure it's not recommended to do this, but I discovered by accident, if you leave the lens cap on when you turn it on, it'll shoot it off by itself. That's pretty funny. And the background music in this video has been brought to you by 105.9 WQXR, classical music station, and 88.3 WBGO Jazz 88 from Newark, New Jersey. Both very good stations for free background music for videos.